A friend of mine, it must have been over 30 years ago, he was a thoracic surgeon, knew I had high cholesterol, and he said to me, take an aspirin a day. And I think it's over 30 years that I've been taking an aspirin a day. I changed from a whole aspirin years ago.
To a baby?
To a baby, because my nose, in the middle of the night when I was sleeping, started to bleed.
Yeah.
And it woke me up right away, and so I changed to a baby aspirin, and I've been taking it ever since, I believe, and I'm not a medical doctor.
Yeah.
I believe that the thinner the blood, the better the heart is going to work than if you have thicker blood.
Of course.
So what do you think about an aspirin a day?
Well, here's the deal on aspirin. For secondary prevention, like if you had heart disease, I like an aspirin every other day or a baby aspirin a day. I do like it. I support it. And plus, I saw this as a clinical cardiologist, and the data supports it in the large randomized trials. However, when it comes to primary prevention for healthy people, I do not like an aspirin a day, because between 19 and 20,000 people a year die of GI bleeding from aspirin. It's not an innocuous, you were lucky. You woke up with a nosebleed that an angel came to you and gave you a nosebleed instead of a GI bleed, because a GI bleed first time around can be fatal. So you're a lucky guy, you know, count your blessings. Now, in your case, I saw your HDL, it was in the mid 20s. So your thoracic surgeon inadvertently did a great thing for you. Because when you have low HDL, like I said before, it thins the blood. It thickens the blood. Yeah, low HDL thickens the blood. So when you take an aspirin, it thins the blood. So now you're overcoming a vulnerability of the low HDL. You're neutralizing it. So that was a good thing. Even the researchers in the West of Scotland study said that the statins that these smoking men with low HDL was working on a different mechanism. They said back then it had to do with blood viscosity and plasma viscosity, meaning the thickness of the blood. Those researchers also suggested that statins were changing the shape of red blood cells going through the spleen, making it more slippery, so to speak. So we call out those the pleiotropic effects of statins. So in your case with the low HDL, because your risk of heart disease was higher, your thoracic surgeon did a good thing. Thank God you had a nosebleed and you went down to a lower dose because you're a lucky guy. In other words, any drug, whether it's aspirin, I don't care, any drug can have a downside. And we need to be cautious that drugs can cause harm. Remember this, Sal. Remember this. The fourth leading cause of death in America today, following heart disease, cancer, stroke. Number four is properly prescribed pharmaceutical drugs. Properly prescribed pharmaceutical drugs. So if we can get by without pharmaceutical drugs, by all means do it. And look, in some circumstances, we must use pharmaceutical drugs.
Right.
So I'm not vilifying pharmaceutical drugs, but I'd rather have people use more diligence and maybe choose alternatives for situations that they can obviously live with.